power, yeah. I don't need nobody, I go kamikaze. Smoking on that broccoli, I go kamikaze. I don't need nobody, I go kamikaze. Smoking on that broccoli, Rami Kawasaki. Hello guys, RamiX back for another video. Today's video that I would suggest is What If Naruto Had the Edo Tensei Part 2 and or the Reanimation Jutsu in English. And the like goal for this video is going to be 300 likes to guarantee another part, followed closely behind this one in 250 likes to just guarantee another part in general. So make sure to like, share, comment down below, check out my Discord server in the description of the video, and subscribe as my goal is to get 2,000 subscribers by March and 10,000 subscribers by the end of the year. And watch the very end, as I have ads placed in within this video. That would be amazing if you watch them, but you don't have to. Anyhow, we left off with Naruto reanimating the first and second Hokage, as well as Shisui Uchiha and Kagami Uchiha. Naruto would then cast the tiger and monkey hand seal, slamming his hands into the ground. Him doing this would ensure that they don't escape and that they can obtain their previous power through a tachonesis, if you will. As well as their previous knowledge, Naruto would then be greeted by Kakashi, who would tell Naruto that they will go on a C-rank mission after they complete a few D-ranks, if he was wondering. Kakashi would say this because he would, well, hypothesize that Naruto would be very bored at the D-rank missions, as his fight with him determined that Naruto is above the level of a genin. After Naruto was told this by Kakashi, he would do various missions like finding cats, cleaning stuff, cutting wood, and things of the sort, D-rank missions. Naruto would complete 10, getting bored and asking Lord Third to take a week break. Haruzen would ponder this, asking Naruto why he would want to take a break. Naruto would then tell Haruzen that he had to train for whatever big mission Kakashi had told Naruto about. As Haruzen then remembered Kakashi asking for his team to go on a C-rank mission, Haruzen would tell Naruto that a week break to train is okay, as long as he doesn't get too hurt. Naruto would then smile, running back to the cave where he had reanimated the first and second Hokage and Shisui Uchiha, as well as Kagami, who wanted to be revived as to see his son, Shisui. Naruto would immediately start training with these ninja as he told them to go all out. Naruto would then be met with a punch from Tobirama and then a fireball from Shisui. The Kekkei of the Uchiha clan, Uchiha style great fireball jutsu. This was enough to make Naruto fall to the ground on one knee, as Hashirama's wood style would then wrap around Naruto's body, being flung into the roof of the cave. Naruto would get up from this attack. A tactic of sorts. Naruto would then notice that the first Hokage and Shisui are no joke and wanted to test, well, the second Hokage. Naruto would be dazed from the attack, realizing that he is unable to combat even just one of them, so he should make the Edo Tensei teach him their jutsu. Naruto would then be met with a punch from Tobirama, being sent flying, as this hypothesis by Naruto in theory, well, was completely true. He would then make the Edo Tensei teach him their jutsu. Naruto would then tell them to teach him their jutsu and knowledge. Shisui would ask Naruto if he has the Shadokan jutsu. Naruto would say, yeah, creating 10 clones. Shisui would explain the Shadokan training technique, taking two of Naruto's clones to be taught how to manipulate fire and lightning. So the only change I have to make here is Naruto being born with all chakra natures. Genetic luck, if you will. Anyhow, Naruto would then learn jutsu for all of his chakra natures and would challenge Tobirama to a duel. While his clones trained with Hashirama and Shisui, Naruto would immediately launch a punch at the former Hokage. Tobirama would block this hit, grabbing Naruto's fingers and using them to make a jutsu, similar to how Sasuke did with Naruto at the Final Valley. A massive water dragon missile would then appear, being launched at Naruto. Naruto would jump back using the mud wall jutsu to block the attack. Naruto would then pull out 6 kunai, 3 in each hand, throwing them all perfectly in sync at Tobirama, a move Shisui had taught him himself. Naruto would then unsheathe the blade that Kagami had entrusted to him, jumping around in an unorthodox way, slicing his blade through the air, engulfed with fire. As he yelled Uchiha style halo dance, flames would then fly towards Tobirama, who would use a water wall to block these flames. Naruto would then be bombarded with smoke, unable to see. As he activated his 2 Tamori Sharingan, he would then be able to see clearly and only didn't activate the 3 Tamori as to reserve chakra. 3 kunai would then be sent towards Naruto. Tobirama would then teleport to these kunai. This was the Flying Raijin. Unsheathing his sword and slicing Naruto, Naruto would then fall to the ground, grabbing his chest as blood sporadically spurted from the wound. Naruto would dig deeper into the Kyuubi's chakra. His eyes would become slit-like, teeth archaic, whiskers more defined, and 3 tails at his collarbone area. Naruto had entered the 3-tailed state. Naruto would then heal his wounds, jumping up and hitting Tobirama. He was lucky and happy that he was able to control this much of the 9-tailed chakra. If it weren't for his Sharingan, he wouldn't be able to. He would then hit Tobirama repeatedly, as Tobirama would be repeatedly put back together by the Edo Tensei itself. He would then congratulate Naruto on being able to beat an 80% him. Naruto would say that he hadn't beat him yet, at least not yet, creating 1,000 shadow clones, all amped by the 3-tails Kyuubi chakra form. These clones would enrich a beating on Tobirama and would leave Naruto tired and on his last legs. A 3 Tamori Sharingan pattern would then appear in Naruto's eyes as he would stand up, creating 5 clones who would then perform the 5 chakra nature's jutsu. Naruto would then hold off one of Tobirama's sealing kunai. It was the last one in his possession. Throwing it in front of him as he prepared all of his chakra into one blow, Naruto's plan was to basically steal Tobirama's last kunai, forcing him to teleport to it with a big onslaught. As Naruto prepared all of his chakra into one blow, he knew that this was it for Tobirama, alive or Edo, as he would then force Tobirama to dodge, going to his kunai, which Naruto planned for, hitting Tobirama at the last second, twisting his arm and clawing into him, destroying his armor. Naruto would then grab Tobirama's headguard, judo slamming him to the ground as it twisted his arm, almost breaking the tendons, but not completely. Naruto would then wake up, fresh off of his Uzumaki healing regen, mixed with the Kyuubi's chakra, training even harder as he only had 3 more days to train with them before the Land of Waves. Naruto would then be told by Hiruzen, who had heard a lot of noises and commotion coming from the cave, checking in on Naruto. He only wasn't shocked at seeing the reanimated shinobi because, well, he never saw them. They were hidden, and Hiruzen saw the chakra and believed it as coming from the 9-tails, as it is a pretty menacing chakra. Anyhow, Hiruzen would then tell Naruto that the mission they're going on is an S rank, so get in as much training as you can, and it will be a great chance for experience. Naruto would smile. Yes, it will be a very good, experience test for me, and we'll see how strong I am on the battlefield, as he left Naruto. Naruto would then continue his training, learning even more jutsu, which I won't list now, but will eventually. Naruto, by the end of the time, had easily become Hokage Kage level with the aid of the Kyuubi, as Naruto would then dispel the jutsu. Naruto, seeing all of his mentors leave, would awaken Kagami's MS. Naruto would then walk out of the cave, ready for the Land of Waves, as they would approach a puddle. Sasuke would deal with the Demon Brothers, as Naruto was about to aid, but could sense that Sasuke was more than enough to deal with the two. Naruto would pick up on that they were not after Kakashi, they were after Tazuna. His first thought was Kakashi, as he is the legendary copy ninja of the Leaf, but after first glance, it had seemed that they were after Tazuna, as his goal was to build a bridge. In the debrief of the mission, it said that it was to make trading goods available. Also, just so you know, I'm not changing anything in the canon, Tazuna has enough money here, he's not broke, so he's able to pay for an S-rank mission. The Leaf also has multiple Anbu on guard in a 600-meter radius that are slowly approaching where Team 7 is. In the case of Team 7 losing this battle, which they do need the 9-tailed Jinchuriki, so they couldn't afford for it to be gone. Naruto wouldn't have to make a pledge to himself because he was never scared of the Demon Brothers or didn't step in. He just knew Sasuke's capabilities and let him handle it, as they would then appear before Zabuza and Haku. We will be skipping their first encounter as well as the Inari scene, which goes as same in canon. Since it's the same, basically, the Zabuza and Haku's first fight with Naruto in Team 7. Except for the fact that Naruto blocks some attacks with the help of his sword that Kagami entrusted him. This sword will be referred to as Naruto's sword instead of Kagami's from now on. Even though Kagami may be reanimated at times. Naruto, Sasuke, and Kakashi would then prepare to fight the duo of Haku Yuki and Zabuza Momochi. Anyhow, this is where I'll be ending the part, so make sure to like, as the like goal is 300 likes to guarantee another part, followed closely behind this one, and 250 for just another part in general. So make sure to share the video to someone who likes What Ifs, comment in, well, the comment section, check out my Discord server in the description down below, subscribe as I want to hit 2,000 subscribers by March. You can also do that by sharing the video, and tell me down below if you want me to do discussion videos or like character timelines on certain characters, like say Madara or Shisui. Those videos will probably be roughly about like 20 minutes at most, hopefully around that range at least. Anyways, as always, Rami X out.